I've been hilariously working on all day today trying to get somehow things consolidated so I could get other things done, like blogs and websites, that they, it's almost as though when you start to do things, well, kind of like this porch, when you take a plant, you put it in a little pot, you know, you water it, you grow it, you cut it off, you know, a little, say a little branch, and then you put that one in a pot, and it grows, and you water it, and then you put another one in a pot, and it grows. It just seems to go and go and go and go. Sometimes, I don't know about you, but sometimes in ministry, in when God is going to bless you, sometimes you kind of go through that, where it's just like everything's growing all at once. It takes off like a life of its own, and it just runs off in every direction, and I love it. You know, it's like devotional has become a joy, and it's a challenge because it's a lot of work, but it's fun, you know, and it's exciting because it's like it's part of my inner being that comes out, and I enjoy being a part of it. But then there's, like, I started a news service that I've been doing for a long time now, and it's Last Generation Network News, and the sections in it have been fun to develop, but now it's like they've expanded too, and they're growing like crazy. And it's like, oh boy, you know, as the ministry seems to expand itself outward and was huge to begin with, that I'm just amazed at, you know, just, my wife says, how do you keep track? And I said, do you think I'm keeping track? Not even. I said, I haven't a clue what's going on. I said, it's just all over the place. Praise the Lord. And I like that. It's, with God in control, you just get to kind of like go along and look like you know what you're doing. The only thing I know is he knows what he's doing, and I'm along for the ride. In Spurgeon, in Evotional, forget not all his benefits, from Psalm 2, or Psalm something 2. It is a delightful and profitable occupation to mark the hand of God in the lives of ancient saints, and to observe his goodness in delivering them, his mercy in pardoning them, and his faithfulness in keeping his covenant with them. But would it not be even more interesting and profitable for us to remark the hand of God in our own lives? Ought we not to look upon our own history as being at least as full of God, as full of his goodness and of his truth, as much a proof of his faithfulness and veracity as the lives of any of the saints who have gone before? Shouldn't our lives be like those we read about? We do our Lord an injustice when we suppose that he wrought all his mighty acts and showed himself strong for those in the early time, but does not perform wonders or lay bare his arm for the saints who are now upon the earth. That's not true. Let us review our own lives. Surely in these we may discover some happy incidences, some refreshing to ourselves and glorifying to our God. Have you had no deliverances? Has God not rescued you? Have you passed through no rivers supported by the divine presence? Have you walked through no fires unharmed? Have you had no manifestations? Have you had no choice favors? Has God not been personal to you? Has he spoken directly to you? The God who gave Solomon the desire of his heart, hath he never listened to you and answered your requests? That God of lavish bounty, of whom David sang, who satisfies thy mouth with goodness, with good things, hath he never satiated you with fatness? Lately, yes, me. Have you ever been made to lie down in green pastures? Have you never been led by the still waters? Surely the goodness of God has been the same to us as to the saints of old. Let us take the pure gold of thankfulness and the jewels of praise and make them into another crown for the head of Jesus. Let our souls give forth music as sweet and as exhilarating as came from David's harp, while we praise the Lord, whose mercy endures forever. He's so eloquent and articulate. and percipient, or percipient, percipient, one of those ants. And yet, in all of these things, he makes the point which is correct. Your life is a living epistle. God is writing his living word in you, of you, about you, and through you. You have become his word of God to those around you, and they are reading your life as you're living it. So too are the angels. So too are those who are experiencing Jesus as he lives in you and as you share him with others, as he is becoming more evident in your life daily. Isn't that cool? I think so. You know, I think that there's no greater joy than to know that God is with me. And because he's with me, I can't help but think that. How intimate do you want to be with God is just simply how real you recognize that he is Emmanuel, God with us, and God in us.